Naslov razstave se imenuje Disappearance in the Air is called Mirage in je v bistvu vzeto iz, bi rekla, nekega širšega konteksta internetnega raziskovanja, pač določene besede, ki me je zanimala pri tej razstavi in sicer privid. Zdelo se nama je s Petrom, da dejansko oba raziskujeva te neke ne nadnaravne, ampak mogoče samo neke nekonkretne pojave, ki se pač dogajajo v zraku zdaj, s tem pogledom, usmerjenem v atmosfero. In zato se nama je zdel, da bi en tak naslov lahko bil zelo poetičen in bi pasal v bistvu k vsem delom, ne, ker je zelo odprt. Hkrati pa se zelo dobro povezuje z mojimi slikami in pa s Petrovimi.
Well, the preparations of this show was very smooth, as both of us, me and Suzy, we know each other aesthetics and we are kind of updated by social medias and by our normal communication in life. So this is something that you are not, that we were not really like have to focus on, as we are orientated in the artistic path that we are like walking on, both of us. So we set up some base elements, then we work, discuss and make the final process in here as a part of the show, because like it's very important to set up correctly the whole scene, the whole exhibition.
Bi rekla, da sem se odmaknila na nek način od tega, kar sem prej delala. Pač moja zadnja velika serija je bila, so bili mostovi in bi rekla, da tiste slike so bile zelo mrežaste, zelo tudi kompleksne in v bistvu skozi nek razvoj in proces sem prišla do bolj organskosti, do več organskosti. In da so slike mogoče bolj odprte, bolj zračne, kar v bistvu tudi zelo dobro sovpada samo temu raziskovanja in tudi samega slikarstva. Zadnja serija je nastala v bistvu v letu 2020 in 2021. Je v bistvu do nedavnega so slike nastajale v mojem ateljeju v Leipzigu. In slike so razdeljene nekako na dva sklopa, ki sta tudi predstavljena oba tukaj na razstavi in se malo tudi razlikujeta. Oba sklopa nekako vsebujeta iste teme, s katerimi prepletam te ideje, ampak na drugačne načine. Zato v tem večjem prostoru sem se v bistvu bolj nanašala na neko odprtost, na neko igranje. Zanimal me je predvsem ta pogled navzgor, pogled v odprtost, v širino, v atmosfero, v zrak in kaj vidimo oziroma kakšna je naša percepcija tega. Tako da so ta sklop v večjem prostoru je v bistvu bolj odraz tega, kako jaz doživljam te oblake, te pojave, ki se dogajajo v bistvu, ki so zelo vsakdanji, ampak pač skozi nek drug princip. Zanimalo me je tudi veliko, kako dojemamo to skozi tehnologijo, kakšen vpliv ima to na nas skozi tehnologijo. Recimo tudi, kako se, ko opazujemo razno razne slike sončnih zahodov na Instagramu ali na drugih socialnih medijih, kako to v bistvu vpliva na nas, zakaj imamo to potrebo, da to delimo z drugimi, ker gre v bistvu za res nekaj posebno vsakdanjega. In ravno zaradi tega prepleta s to tehnologijo me je začel tudi zanimati v bistvu pogled navzgor skozi to tehnološko plat, in sicer v smislu, kako opazujemo nebo, se pravi z razno raznimi teleskopi, kaj v bistvu potrebujemo za sprejemanje in oddajanje razno raznih pač teh valov, da lahko sploh v bistvu komuniciramo med sabo in tako naprej. Tudi en dogodek, ki me je v bistvu zelo fasciniral, je bilo na začetku epidemije so recimo v vesolje v nižjo orbito začeli pošiljati na tisoče Starlinkovih satelitov za nov internet. In v bistvu je to povzročilo, da so astronomi imeli zelo velik problem z opazovanjem nočnega neba, vesolja. In v bistvu te obstrukcije so nekako so bile zelo zanimive, kako je to v bistvu bilo bolj pokazano v samih teh slikah. V drugem sklopu slik so torej slike, ki se nanašajo bolj na to tehnološko gledanje neba, zato so v bistvu slike tudi bolj pretežno tehnično narejene in mogoče na ta način. V bistvu trudila sem se nekako še zmero ohranjati to odprtost slike kot pri prvem sklopu, pa vendar je veliko več kombinacij z črtami, z mrežami, in se mi zdi, da morda bolj nazorno prikazujejo v bistvu stvari, ki sem jih raziskovala.
The body of the works on displayed on the exhibition is basically based on my residency stay in Olomouc, Czech Republic, sooner this year before summer. And basically it was like a changement of series, as I finished one that I was working on for like 2 years, and this was like the first series afterwards. So I changed a little the game with the formal, from the formal side, as I started to work with raw canvases, and afterwards it started to, the conception started to be built it up on this feeling that the painting is starting from the middle point, not from the beginning of the blank background. So with the perception of this by method of painting, I just realized like I want to make something that is very airy inside, that it's not so classically painted in such a situation mode or in such an enclosed space. I work in a series usually, and for me this series was beginning of the new part of the work, I would say. The methodic didn't change that much, as I do not use any photography or any digital images as a sketch for the painting. So this base is important and it stays. But what I started to work on is basically I started to work more with abstract science. So the bright image is kind of falling apart by abstraction, by fragmentation of what I saw, and then transmission maybe more feelings on the canvases than static situations. This is very common in the question of the memories, that there are some blur parts. So for me, these blur parts or mistakes of my memories is a possibility to make the painting interventions and working more with the language of painting itself, like for example gestures or overlaying with a different scene or putting there another artificial light or possibilities like these, I would say. This is like for me, these mistakes in the memories or the faded parts are very good as the as the working space for painting itself and to use it as a medium, as a transmitter. If I should define my style somehow, I work a lot with lines, diagonals and kind of dynamics in the painting. Of course it's evaluating with time, and sometimes I'm getting back to some approaches, sometimes I'm just trying to figure out the new possibilities. But mostly I would say like layers and the cutting in between realities, the meeting of two realities at least at one picture. Meeting of the stories in the picture. And also I can say for like last 3 years I'm working on a genre that is landscape. And now in the new series I'm going to observe the new genre, not new, it's very traditional genre, but for me it's also important to somehow comment the traditional possibility of painting with implementation of the contemporary technique, science or some, yeah. Since my studies, I can say I was finding out this edge of balancing position in between figurative and abstract. What I really do like is the composition. So basically, my first two cornerstones on the of the new piece are what is the atmosphere and the light, and then the other part is what is the composition itself. So by the composition and the perspective and the lines, I can transmit the feeling about some specific space, closed, public or private, from the interiors to the open landscapes. But on the other hand, by composition, I also put there these abstract approaches or abstract significant composition fragments. It's like the interchange in between what I feel, what I see, and what I can compose as a synthetic reality, we can say. Synthetic reality as you're starting from the point that there is no certain image you want to paint. So you're basically like building it up from the first line and the first light, and you're building it up to the point where it presents some possibility of reality. It's not the reality itself which is what is communicated. The thing is the feeling of the of possibility of reality, so that we can somehow experience the painting itself.
Barvna paleta je v bistvu zelo odprta. Ko sem v bistvu spremljala vse te sončne zahode in pojave in tako naprej, so se začele pojavljati določene barve, ki so nekako izstopale. Gre za predvsem neke tople barve in pa večinoma modre. In sem dejansko po recimo teh inspiracijah iz fotografij vzemala določene odtenke barv, ki sem jih potem uporabljala pač znotraj same slike. Pri nekaterih slikah sem se navezovala tudi na slike oziroma barvne odtenke tudi kakšnih starih mojstrov, recimo Williama Turnerja ali pa rokoko slikarja Tiepola. Predvsem mi je bilo zanimivo, ker so se tudi one dva oba ukvarjala s temi pogledi, temi atmosferičnimi pogledi, oblakov in tako naprej. Zakaj točno ona dva, ne vem, ampak enostavno sta prišla mi nekako nasproti. In sem v bistvu po njih na to iskala določene barvne odtenke, ki sta jih zelo rada uporabljala in jih probala nekako aplicirati pač na svojo sliko. Gre pa tudi materialno v bistvu za določene razlike med slikami, kjer se v bistvu zelo rada poigram v bistvu s samim materialom, tako kot pač na način, da je barva ista recimo, ampak material drugi. Torej, ne vem, vse skupaj v bistvu izpade neka taka atmosferična igra.
My approach to colors in general changed quite a lot in the last 3-4 years, I would say. Nowadays, my main inspirations are somehow so in nature or in my daily life. And then I try to communicate these tensions in between the colors that I see in real life, but not in realistic way, that they are not really like detailed and so on. I work more with the color as a body then, and the colors come from nature or from my daily life. But of course, it's a very different approach if you're starting from such a neutral tone, because then the colors are less shiny or more shiny in the contrast. It depends on your approach to the painting itself, to each piece.